Okay, so now that Martin's given you a little taste of XSLT, we'll talk more about the details, or some of the details of XSLT, because there are a lot we're not going to be able to cover today. First thing to remember, to keep in the back of your mind the whole time we're talking about this, is that the input XML file, as far as XSLT is concerned, is a tree. You, the human, may not think of it that way naturally, but you'll find XSLT is easier to understand and use if you think of the input as a tree. When stripped down to its basics, the XSLT stylesheet is a root XSL colon stylesheet element with a series of XSL template elements inside it. Each XSL template element is a child of stylesheet. There are no XSL templates inside other XSL templates or anywhere else. So we have XSL stylesheet with a series of XSL templates, and that's it. Let's take a look at that. Here's a bird's eye view, an overview of an XSLT stylesheet. You'll notice at the top there's some kind of potentially scary looking stuff. We'll go over that in more detail later. What I want to focus on now is the main part of the stylesheet, which is a series of XSL colon template elements. It doesn't matter what order these templates are in, and there's nothing else in the style sheet except the series of XSL templates. A template, according to Wiktionary, is a generic model or pattern from which other objects are based or derived. Fair enough. That's how the XSL template element gets its name. An XSL template is also a generic model or pattern, in this case of XML, from which the output is derived. Here's an example of a normal non-XML template. In this case, this is a party game for children. A story is displayed. The template is of a story with blanks, giving the user of the story what kind of words should be filled in the blank. Other people in the party fill in the words without knowing the story, and then supposedly at the end when you read it, there's a humorous result. Well, a simple XSL template operates on exactly the same principle. There's structure, stuff that gets used directly, and then there are parts that are filled in. In this case, the parts that are filled in is the one XSL value element in light blue. That's the same element that Martin used earlier to show you how to count the speeches in Hamlet, right? The rest of the template content, the dark blue elements, are a simple HTML document that just gets copied over into the output. Essentially, the XSL processor takes the content of the template and moves it to the output after processing the XSL instructions that are inside. They're the filling in the blanks part. In XSLT, each of those templates matches some part of the input XML tree. When the processor gets to that part of the tree, the template is executed. A template knows what it matches, or we, the humans, know what the template matches, by looking at the match attribute of the template element. That match attribute is expressed in XPath and tells us what parts of the input tree that template knows how to process. It's worth keeping in mind that we have three XML documents involved in this process. The first is the input document, in our case, TEI. The second is the program itself, the XSLT stylesheet, which we're learning how to write now. And last is the output document, which in this case is going to be XHTML. The question we have is, how do we differentiate which bits of our program are in which language? TEI, XSLT, and XHTML. Well, all of the element names in the match and select attributes are from the input document and so are in the TEI. All of the elements that start with the XSL colon prefix are instructions to the XSL program. And all of the other elements, the ones that don't have a prefix, are output elements, in this case, XHTML. The top part of the XSL stylesheet that I skipped over before and called housekeeping is how we tell the XSLT processor which is the input, which is the output, and which is the stuff for it. Here is that bit at the top again reproduced, that housekeeping section reproduced. The highlighted portion in the red box is the attribute that tells the processor when you see an element name in a match or select attribute, it's from the given namespace, which in this case is the TEI namespace. This bit tells the processor things prefixed with XSL colon are things in the XSLT namespace, and this bit tells the processor those elements without a prefix come from the XHTML namespace. These namespaces themselves are somewhat long and complex strings for humans to type, and we recommend to always copy and paste them, never to try to type them by hand. Making a single mistake in that namespace can ruin your entire program. Ask me how I know.